This program contains strong language and sexual references throughout.
Flashing lights, the timing is right, it's the time of your life. Go, go, when it all comes to
fruition. My boyfriend. Hey,
I don't really need to take. I've woken up in bed this morning with my girlfriend, a Playboy model.
My girlfriend.
Joey Essex is 100% bang in love right now.
This is my gladiator partner dance.
Waking up with David McIntosh in my bed is like, sorry, let me take a minute. He is everything that I've dreamt of in a man. 6 foot, muscly, he's just insane.
His arm is massive.
He was your pillow.
Yeah, and he was like that, and I was just like, he's so cute. Plus, he's actually such a nice guy.
Oh, I love him.
So nice.
Do you know what? I'm feeling the love so much right now.
Are you?
Yeah,
sometimes,
like
I don't even think, like, I feel like sometimes I'm waking up and it's a dream. Do you know what I mean? Like, he's like my dream guy.
Can we give a round of applause for the new couple?
Yay! I'm so glad the plan went to plan last night.
Ash and George put the work in, so, you know.
That's really?
Real sweet.
Who did the heart and everything?
Ashley hand cut all of them hearts.
That is so cute.
Ashley's a great catch. Someone's going to be really lucky with him.
Things between me and Ellie are over. She kind of friend-zoned me. I can't lie right now. I'm looking at Georgia. She is looking fine.
So, girls, you know, you had a chat last night. Is everything cool?
We pretty much see eye to eye, and there's no bad blood here. There never was.
There never was. We just needed to think, like, air things out. But we're really good now.
No time's that threesome.
She's trying to lighten the mood.
I don't care to be in no trilogy or foursome or whatever it is you're doing. Like, I don't play little baby games.
You know, I've had enough.
I'm really sick of this baby bullshit now.
It was a total joke. It was a joke.
Don't even stir nothing right now, because I am seeing a little red. You know what I'm saying right now.
With Marissa, there must be some sort of feelings between her and Callum, otherwise she wouldn't be getting feisty about it. Right now in the villa, Michael's probably the only one that's caught my eye. We'll just have to see what happens.
And speaking of decisions, David needs to make one pronto with Letitia, because her plans for a cozy future together didn't appear to go down too well with the big fella.
At this moment in time, all I can think of is somebody coming in who I know and then being isolated.
You don't want your ex to feel isolated. Just fair enough.
That's for me. I just feel like that. No, I think that, yeah, I know, but I'm just feel for me.
Well, I can tell you straight from now, if any of my exes come in, I would not give a shit.
I don't want to treat you like an idiot because you're a respectful woman, you're a cool, you know what I mean?
If it wasn't... but like I'm telling you now, from now, if you feel like you have any feelings towards your ex,
it's not like a
then like, just leave this, because I don't want even want to get into it.
Really? Genuinely? I wish I didn't even like you. You know why? Because if I didn't like you, it'd be easy for me.
I feel like one major issue is going to be us sleeping in the same bed together. Right? Yeah?
I guess so.
This is why I was keeping my guard up, because I had a feeling like something in the back of my mind was telling me not to fully give myself to this guy. Because, yeah, he's... I don't even know what to say.
You're right.
You basically just said he's a bit scared of his ex coming in and he doesn't want to disrespect her. And I said, look, if my ex come in, I'd happen to be like, he was David. And he was like, yeah, I get that, but I just don't want to disrespect her. I said, if you feel like this is going to disrespect her, then don't sleep in my bed.
Don't feel stupid. The only person that's going to look at that is him.
My time in the villa before David came in was kind of like, ugh. Like, I felt out of place. I felt like there was no one there for me. And then David comes in and literally turns it all upside down, and I felt happy. And now it's kind of just come to an end, and I just feel like so awkward.